I was fortunate before I came to Rockefeller to teach at San Quentin State Penitentiary. And I taught there through what's called the Prison University Project. And there I met students who allowed me to sort of understand the joy of education and the joy of thinking original thoughts. I was inspired by that experience and I saw that and I thought how much that impacted me. And I wanted to pursue further education. We learned from the very beginning that having original thought, having new ideas and tackling new ideas is the bread and butter of our future as scientists. For me, the motto, science for the benefit of humanity, is a major reason why I chose Rockefeller. We're lucky as scientists to be interested in a lot of things. We have labs here that study how dolphins communicate. We have labs here who study the social behavior of ants. We have labs that study neurodegenerative diseases. All of these things are super diverse. But at the same time, they're focused on this mission, which is eventually benefit to humanity. I took a flight from New York to Seattle on the way to a conference, and the guy next to me asked me what I did, and we started to have a conversation. And I started to explain to him about HIV and the kind of research that we're doing here. And he thought about it, and he was quiet, and he asked a lot of questions. And then about 2 hours into the flight, he reached into his vest pocket and took out a big red pill. And he showed it to me, and he said, "I just wanted to tell you that I'm HIV positive. This is the medicine that I take every day. I appreciate what you're doing. Thank you. Keep going. We need you." Meeting somebody who's affected by the thing that you think every day, all day about was really pretty special. I think that that was a big motivation. Being here at Rockefeller and seeing the motivation of everybody around, it's sort of like a big wave and you ride it with everybody else. There's a misconception that doing science is a solitary endeavor, and that couldn't be farther from the truth. Everything that we do at Rockefeller and as scientists happens because we have a great team of people. I do believe that within science especially, but in all fields, that diversity really matters. Diversity in science gives the ability for the group as a whole to see that problem from all the different perspectives of all the different people. When you limit the kinds of people who can attack a problem, you limit the kinds of answers that you might get from that problem. Nothing that I've accomplished happens because I worked alone hard in a lab. That feeling of discovery, that feeling of I just learned something that nobody knows, it happens and it's yours for a moment, but then you share it with your lab mate and you share it with your mentor and you share it with the greater scientific community, and that feedback allows you to get to that next moment of discovery, that next insight. All of it happens because you have a great community around you.